name is Laura Zhang. For the past few months, I have been exploring China to tell the story of cultures. If you've ever lived in China, you will know that we do almost everything online. The online food industry has seen a huge boom and has expanded on an unseen level anywhere else in the world. 343 million users are using the online food industry app to order food online in 2017. That is a user base that is larger than the US population and a quarter of China's population. Today, we are going to get an inside look into the lives of the delivery drivers who make this industry tick. My morning begins at 9:30 in Wangjing, where we're about to attend a routine morning meeting. From Shanxi province. He has been working for Ele.me for 1 year.
你对未来有什么打算呢？我打算做站长。那你每天上班是多长时间呢？一般的话，10个小时左右。
So now we're going to go and experience what it's like to be a delivery driver. And let's pick up our very first order of the day. Let's go.
我们现在去哪家取这个第一个订单呢？菊记。
阿姨你好，帮我拿一下饿了么13号订单。5个，12个，12个。这边很快的，距离不是很远，这单的话运气比较好，几分钟就可以搞定。我们外卖这几年作为一个市场的消费，它是发展的规模越来越大。2016年是1600亿元，2017年是2000多亿元。 2018年是2400多亿元，2019年可能还会增加。也就是说，外卖在餐饮业的消费中，它所占的比重是14%，超过14%，这个比重是比较大的。
We've just received our second order, and we only have 30 minutes to get it and deliver it. So let's go.
火灵里小区，这时间比较赶，加班。
We're about to run out of time for this particular order, so we're gonna try to make it in time, or else our delivery fee actually gets cut in half.
喂，你好，蜂鸟专送，我到门口了，麻烦加餐。
因为现在已经是高峰期了，然后就时间比较紧张，因为现在用餐的人特别多，就是中午饭点。线上订餐服务对你的生意有什么影响呢？给我带来了很多的利益，比如说好多顾客不知道我家店在什么位置，但是他在外卖这个平台上呢，能搜到我家这个餐，这样给我们带来了一些就是额外的这个客流量吧。
Yanpeng, the delivery driver that we met this morning, is part of a growing number of migrant workers who have come to the city to help improve their lives. These delivery drivers are the foundation to China's food industry and has transformed the way that we order food online.